Alright, so let's test out markers on this material. This is just a Crayola marker, regular old style. So I'm gonna make a few marks. Not gonna be too precious about it. This is a fun gray color. So now, one thing I want you to notice is, it smears a lot. And the colors kind of mix together. You could draw something that you really like, but it's ultimately just going to rinse right off of this material because it's an impermeable plastic, so these water-based markers are not going to soak in, and that means your drawing is not going to last. So if you take it outside and fly your kite, your drawing is probably going to come right off. So I would not recommend using markers for this project. It's time for the fun part. So we're gonna decorate this kite sail, and remember, the kite's gonna be kind of like a diamond, so you wanna orient it this way so that the four corners are in a diamond shape. I'm just gonna start with crayon and try that out. And it looks like it's working pretty well on the tyvek. Not gonna overthink this. And you can draw anything that you want on your kite. This is just trying out some materials. So there's a hand. Now crayons are kind of waxy, so they're gonna resist an ink layer if I were to do a wash over this. Here's the exciting part. Got a soft brush and some black ink. I'll show you the original container, actually. So this is black sumi ink. It might also look like this, two different kinds here. But this ink is really, works really well with tyvek. It'll dry and it won't scratch off, so I like to use this for these kinds of projects with the tyvek sail because the ink soaks in really well and it makes nice washes. So what I'm expecting to happen is the crayon will resist the ink. The ink will soak into the tyvek where there isn't crayon applied to it. So let's see if that works. This is something I've never done before. I'm going to try something else now. I've got a couple things to try scraping with. See if this works. Looks pretty cool. So this is an actual stylus that's kind of designed for scraping. I'll try the X-Acto knife as well. But perhaps you have something around your home that you can use. Just lets you kind of make an interesting line. So you can bring out the features of what you drew. Let's try using this needle. So you're getting some marks with that. It's one idea. And then here's an X-Acto. So this is very sharp, so definitely a parental supervision thing, but there might be something else like the edge of a scissor or the edge of a ruler that you could use to scrape with. That also works. Decorate your kite however you want. This is just one idea. It's kind of fun if you have ink and crayons. So there's a hand. Call that done. So now let's look at another example. All right, so we're gonna try out another material. This time it's gonna be golden acrylics. So any acrylic paint that you have laying around the house right now would do. This happens to be a really fancy one. I also only have one color. I have red, so we're gonna work with that for the test. But this is really just to see if the acrylic paint will stick nicely to the tyvek. So I am going to put a little bit of the plain paint on my brush, unthinned. The brush is already a little bit wet. And I'm gonna go with something real simple and traditional. Just gonna make a heart. And just see how this paint works on this material. Step one for any artist is finding the right materials. So far, it feels great. So I can see that the wetness of the brush is playing a little bit into this. I have some thicker, more dried out paint in the cap and the lid here. So I just dip my brush in that to get some pure, thicker paint. This is a good time to think about what you want to send into the sky. There might be a word or some kind of meditation that you feel you want to paint onto your kite sail. In this case, it's just a heart, which is, of course, a little message of love. Put some more marks on here just to really test it out. Dip my brush in water. We're going to try a wash, see how that looks. Wash is glorious. Look at that. It's really soothing to paint, not to think about anything and just paint. Alright, try just scratching one in, see how that works. Scratching a bit of a design in. So there you have it. You can work subtractively by scratching away the paint and putting your design in that way. Or you can work by applying the paint with a brush. I'm just making marks just to test some ideas out, but there you go.